Hello guys, welcome back to this channel and thanks for viewing this video. And today we are going to talk about key bindings. So what is a key binding? A key binding is the fact of binding an action to a particular keystroke. And one other thing that we need to note about key binding is that all swing components can use key binding, and you can assign keystroke to individual swing components. And also, key binding does not require you to click on a component in order to give it focus. The difference between key binding and then key listener is that key binding is more flexible, but it is more difficult to use or utilize and set up. So, all right. So this is how my project is organized. Apart from the main class that I have here containing my main method, I have created a new class that I called key binding. In that new class, I'm going to create a constructor. So I would say public key underscore binding, open the brackets, open and close the curly braces. And then in the main method, I need to create an instance of my key binding class. So I'll simply come down here and say key underscore binding. I will call this instance key binding underscore demo. And I'll say new key underscore binding. Open and close the bracket, then semicolon. In the key binding class, we are going to create some inner classes that will be used to define some actions. So let me come here and I will say private class. This will be called left action. And it's going to inherit from the abstract action class. So I need to write extends abstract action. Open and close the curly braces. So that's it. I need to import the abstract action class, and then I need to add on implemented methods. I'm going to add another inner class. This time around, I will call it write action. Private class write action. It's going to extend the abstract class as well. And I need to add on implemented methods. Okay, action performed. The next thing I'm going to add will be another inner class, and I will call it app action, like this. And this app action will also contain an action performed method. I will add another inner class. I think that's going to be the last inner class to be added. I will call it down action, down like this. And it will also contain the action performed method. Now we are going to create some action objects globally, just right before the constructor here. So we will say action, left action, semicolon, add another one, action, right action, semicolon, action, down action, and then action, up action. So let's import the action class like this. What other thing we can do is that we're going to declare a frame. So we will say JFrame. I'll call it my frame. And then another GUI component will be a label that we will declare here. So let us import the various classes. So now we are going to instantiate the frame and the other GUI components in our constructor. So let me instantiate my frame. So I will say my underscore frame assignment operator new JFrame. I need to set the title. So I will say demo key binding. So you can put whatever title you want for your frame, and I will continue adding some more attributes to the frame. This is going to be default close operation JFrame that exit on close. What else do I need? I will add the size of this frame. So I'll say set size, and I need to specify the dimensions. So 800 for the width and then 600 for the height. Let me set the layout. I'll set it to null. And then I will set the visibility of the frame. So this is really important. If not set, our frame won't show whenever we run our program. All right. We will instantiate the label as well. So we say label assignment operator new J label like this. We won't set the text. We will rather set the background color. So that will be label that set background color that blue. let me import the color class. So for the background color to actually pick, we need to set opaque to true. And then let's add label. Now we will set the bounds of the label first. So let's say 50, 50, 100, 100, or maybe 200, 200, both for the width and for the height. So once that is done, we will say my underscore frame dot add label. So this is going to be useful for adding our label to the frame. Let me run and just see if, okay, now you can see our label has been added to the frame. All right. So after doing that, we need to instantiate our keystroke actions. If you recall, we declared our action objects here. We need to instantiate them in the constructor. So the first one, we called it left action. We will create left action of type left action. So this left action is making reference to the inner class we created down here. You see, we have our inner class left action here. So we will copy and paste and customize this for the other actions. So the next one was right action. It's going to be an instance of the inner class called right action. This will be down action, and it's going to be an instance of down action class. So make sure that, you know, the class here must start with a capital letter. And then up action will be a new instance of up action. All right, so this is what you need to write in your constructor. So now let's start working on each of the inner classes. So we will begin with the left action inner class, and we have to add an action performed method, which we already did here. And in this action performed method, we are actually going to work on the location of the label. So what we're going to do here is that we want to say that if we are performing a left action, we want our label component to move to the left. All right. So we already did an example like this, but we used key listeners where we had to determine the various key if pressed would perform a certain action of moving the label to the left or to the right, up or down. But here we are going to use key binding. So now in the action performed method, we need to say label that set location. So we will get the label x axis. So because we want it to move the label to the left, so we say -5, and then we will also get the label's y axis and let it remain the same. Okay, because this action, the left action, would only move the label to the left by 5 pixels. All right. Let's copy. Let's come down to the right action class. And as for the right action class, what we're going to change here is that because it's going to be moving to the right, so that means that we need to increase the x axis by 5 pixels. If we come down to the up action, so the up action is used to move the label to the top. That means that the x axis would remain the same, but the y axis must be reduced by 5 pixels. That's for the up action. So I will copy this and then come in my down action. So this is going to be used for moving the label component down. So that means that the y axis needs to be increased. So now what we're going to do, because now if we run, nothing is happening. Okay. The label component is neither moving to the left or to the right, or, you know, nothing is really happening. So what we have to do is we have to map the events to the keystroke. So here we have defined the events that would happen. So we need to map those events to particular keystroke. So we have to do that in the constructor. Okay. Here we will come and say label that get input map. And we will say put the first argument that we need to pass will be keystroke that get keystroke. And in a get keystroke, we will say left. So left here is making reference to the left arrow key. And then the second argument we need to pass here would be our left action instance. Okay, so that's it for the input map. So we need to get the action map. So we will say again, label that get action map and then put. So the first argument will be the left action object. And we'll say left action here. So this means that when we press the left key on the keyboard, it will trigger the action performed method located in the left action in a class. So let's try to see if this works. It's not working. Let's put it like this. Okay, I'm gonna put action here. Let me run. If I press the left key now, you can see that our label is moving to the left. All right, so I made a mistake here. Instead of writing left action, I wrote left actio, okay? So I needed to add N here. All right, so let's do the very same thing for the other actions. So we have done for the left action, we need to do for the right action. So we say label.getInputMap.put keystroke.getKeystroke, and here we will say right. In here, we will say right action. Here, we will also say right action. And right action. All right, so let's run. When we click on the right arrow key, you can see that the label is now moving to the right. And when we click on the left arrow key, it's moving to the left. Now, we have not done for the up and down arrow keys. We will do that just in a couple of minutes. I want my frame to actually show at the center. I will simply say my frame that set location relative to null. This would be okay, I guess. So now it's showing at the middle. It's nicer like this, all right? So let's add the input map and the action map for our down key. So here will be down action, and down action here, all right? So let me run, click on a down arrow key. You see your label is pushed down. When you click on the right, it is pushed to the right. When you click on the left, it is pushed to the left. Okay, so the last action would be the up action. So that's it. We simply come here and say up action again. And then the last one, we'll say up action. All right, so now let's run. When you say up, it's your label is moved to the top. You say down, it's moved down. You say right, it's moved right. You say left, it is moved left. So we have been able to add some key bindings. Okay, so in here we have used the arrow keys, the left, right, up and down arrow keys. So what if we want to change the keys associated to the left action, for example? Instead of using the left arrow key, we want to use the, you know, a character, for example, like the letter A key or the letter L, all right? So what we need to do is to simply come up here and say, you know, in the get keystroke, we will pass a character. So we will say single quote and then put the character L there. So now let's see when I run, if I press on L, you can see that my label is moving to the left because I have associated that character with the left action, okay? So for the right action, I can also associate that with another character, for example, R. Okay, so now when I run and then R, I press on R, you can see that the label is moving to the right. For the down action, I can say D, single quote D like this. For the up action, I can say U. All right, so now let me run. So when I press on D, it is taking me down. When I press on U, it is moving the label up. When I press on L, it's moving it to the left. And I press on R, it's moving to the right. Okay, so now that was it on key bindings. So as you might have noticed, you can either use key bindings or use key listeners to program an application like this one where you are able to move your GUI components from the left to the top to the right by using key strokes. So we did a video where we used the key listener, but now in this video, we have used the key binding. And as you could notice, it's a little bit more complex, but it is useful for you to know. So I hope this video was informative, and please don't forget to like, to share, and subscribe to this YouTube channel for more videos like this one. Let's meet in the next one.